let's just be honest about the video game industry. While graphics have improved immensely, now with AAA titles, it's less about giving you amazing gameplay and more about just having enough bells and whistles to convince you to buy the title. That's why here at What Culture Gaming, we love it when an old classic franchise comes back with all the timeless gameplay and a new lick of paint. I'm Joe Hendry from What Culture Gaming, and this is 7 Video Game Reboots That Blew Us Away. In at number 7, let's begin with Crash Bandicoot Insane Trilogy. The announcement of this game not only set the gaming world alight, but it also captured the imagination of casual gamers, who have fond memories of Crash's original adventures. What's also great is that rather than just rework one of the titles, it packages all three of the originals together into one, giving you maximum nostalgic value. Now, we should probably address the elephant in the room, and that's that there were a few complaints from my What Culture Gaming colleagues about the mechanics of the game, and the Nostalgia Police did not approve. Despite a few issues with the game mechanics, this game was absolutely a worthwhile endeavour, and the core gameplay is still amazing and the visuals are absolutely stunning. Even though you've played all these levels before, it truly succeeds in the sense that it makes you feel like you're discovering them again for the first time whilst giving you that nostalgic high. In at 6, the 2004 edition of Ninja Gaiden. When a series transitions from 2D to 3D, it doesn't always go to plan. No, Sonic's not supposed to- No! Sorry, I just regularly get 3D Sonic flashbacks, but those worries are not an issue here with Ninja Gaiden. Ninja Gaiden got it absolutely right when you're bringing in a series into 3D. Released in 2004, this reboot received huge critical acclaim, being praised for its addictive combat, breakneck speed, and challenging difficulty curve. In short, this is exactly how you bring an old classic right up to speed in a modern era. Number 5. Doom. The original Doom is quite simply a benchmark in gaming. It's like if someone was to remake your favourite classic film. Don't do it unless you're going to do an amazing job. Well, thankfully on this occasion, ID delivered. Also, the soundtrack is one of the best features of the game and comes courtesy of Mick Gordon, and there's an awesome making of video on YouTube that you should check out if you're a fan of the series or sound production in general. The soundtrack makes you feel like a badass when you're doing well and makes you appropriately nervous when something is about to go down. Like the original Doom, this reboot provides a truly immersive experience, and it's well worth a look whether you played the originals or not. Number 4. Metroid Prime. The cool thing about Metroid is that it's always been a work of art from day one. The original Metroid series was so influential, not just in terms of gameplay, but in being able to manufacture a tense atmosphere given the graphical limitations. Check out our Super Nintendo Games You Must Play Before You Die video for more info on the originals. But the cool thing about the Metroid Prime series is that it took the core principles from the 2D adventures and applied them perfectly to a polished 3D environment. There's loads of new tricks and tools, but there's still the same rewarding exploration with challenging puzzles and that terrifying sense of alone in the universe. So, who's looking forward to Samus Returns? In at number 3, Prince of Persia. The original Prince of Persia was a traumatic experience for me as a child. I found it so damn difficult, and what makes things worse is that if you figured out a way to beat the game, if you didn't do it within the very strict timescale, you still failed. So after a childhood of falling on spikes and seeing blood spill everywhere time after time, I was amazed to see the Prince of Persia return for the PS2. Prince of Persia: The Sands of Time takes all the best elements from the likes of Tomb Raider and adds in this really cool time manipulation tool. So if you're going to fall to your death on those damn spikes again, you can just rewind time and try it again. It's not unlimited, so it forces you to make some choices, and overall it's just an extremely polished platformer, and it's an unbelievable rendition on this frustrating classic. In at number 2, Metal Gear Solid. Yes, I am going to class this as a reboot. Imagine if the Metal Gear series had stopped with Metal Gear 2 back in 1990, where the game was released for the NSX. Yes, it had some really cool ideas, but it just seems like the true vision for Metal Gear, with its unparalleled stealthing action and engaging storytelling, required some much needed technological advancements. So after Metal Gear 2, we fast forward to 8 years later, and Kojima treats us to Metal Gear Solid. Gameplay is completely reimagined and transitioned perfectly to 3D on the PlayStation. Metal Gear Solid is rightly heralded as one of the greatest and most influential video games of all time, showing that just because a franchise is old doesn't mean you can't give it a whole new lease of life with modern technological advancements. And in at number 1, it's Sonic 2006. Nope, just kidding, that was terrible. You know what I'm talking about, it's Sonic Mania. You've caught me, the entire video was just a giant excuse to get paid to praise Sonic Mania. Sonic 4 was so painful for me that I have decided to repress it. Repress its horrifyingly awful game physics, complete lack of respect for the originals, and awful running animation that makes me want to throw up every time Sonic moves. So, from now on, Sonic Mania is actually Sonic 4. And you probably know the story by now. Christian Whitehead, aka the Taxman, successfully ported the original games to mobile devices with some awesome new features. People loved it, people hated Sonic Team, and then Taxman, along with Stealth and a bunch of the Sonic fan game community, pitched to Sega and were remarkably given the go-ahead to take the reins of the franchise. The fan community were doing a better job than the actual development team, but credit to Sega, they went with what the fans wanted to see, and the result is amazing. Sonic Mania retains the perfection of the old physics and exists with the same graphical limitations from Sonic CD. In this case, the limitation is a feature because whilst they've kept it simple, they've added dozens of new sprites, which adds a whole new lease of life to the characters and the environments around them. I went back to play Sonic 3 and Knuckles and then just didn't want to, for the first time ever in my adult life, because it felt a little bit dated. That is the first time a Sonic title has made me feel that way about the original run on the Mega Drive or Genesis, and that is exactly what the perfect reboot should do. It gives you all the best bits of the nostalgia from the original and gives you some new fresh features without diminishing what made the gameplay so great in the first place. It mixes new stages with all your old favourites, and there's just no excuse not to go back and try it. It is the ultimate reboot of a gaming franchise. I've been Joe Hendry for What Culture Gaming. We hope you've enjoyed this video. Please make sure you follow us on Twitter here, and also make sure you go to whatculture.com for all your news, reviews, features, and so much more. Please like, share, and subscribe, and make sure you leave your comments to let us know if you think that we've missed anything out. We hope you've enjoyed this video, and we shall see you next time.